Hey guys, how's it going? Hope everybody's doing well out there today. Every once in a while, a new Docker container or project or whatever you want to call it hits my radar when I'm least expecting it. And that actually happened here recently. Somebody over on Mastodon reached out and was like, hey, there's this Docker thing that I think you'd be interested in, you should take a look at. And that's what we're going to do in this video, is we're going to take a look at this Docker image, this Docker container that was brought to me that's called Dockge. Now, I'm not 100% sure if Dockge is the actual correct pronunciation of this container. That's what I've had in my head since I saw it the first time. But if we jump over to the GitHub repository with the FAQs, it says Dockge is a coinage word which was created by the developer, which we're going to talk about him in a minute. And I hope it sounds like Dodge. And that's kind of what solidified it in my brain, is Dockge, Dodge, very close. So that's what we're going to call it in this video. And just a little preface to this, about a year ago, or a little over a year ago, I guess, I made a video about a Docker service, a Docker container called Uptime Kuma. And conveniently, or luckily, or whatever, I'm super excited that this container is also being developed by the same developer. Right there, Lewis Lamb, sponsor of the project, the contributors, Lewis Lamb right there. Let's pop that open real quick. And here it is, that is Uptime Kuma. I love Uptime Kuma. I've been using it since I deployed it for the video that I made. It's my homepage. When I open my browser, that's the first thing I see, is all of the services that I'm monitoring. So I love that the Lewis, or Louis, I'm not sure which pronunciation they prefer, but I'm super stoked that they're working on a new project. And again, that's what we're going to take a look at here. Again, we've got our GitHub repository for this, and links to everything will be in the video description. But basically, it is a fancy, easy to use and reactive self-hosted Docker compose.yaml stack oriented managed. So kind of think of this as an alternative to something like Portainer or Yacht or something like that. It is a Docker container that runs, and its sole purpose is to manage other Docker containers. And I want to share it with you for a couple of reasons. One, if you like this project, it would be amazing if you went over to the GitHub repository and gave it a star. That's kind of like giving a video a thumbs up. It's like saying, hey, I'm interested in this project. You'll also get notifications when there are updates and things like that on your GitHub page. I also like a couple of the features that they have implemented that the Portainer, for instance, has not. And we're going to take a look at that. But I kind of wanted to get out of the way that this is a Docker management solution, much like Portainer or Yacht, just done a little bit differently. And what I want to do next is actually show you the instance that I've got up and running so that you can kind of get a feel for how it works. And then we'll deploy it and we'll take a look through it that way as well. So let's jump back over to my desktop and take a look at my Dockge instance. So this is it, right? This is what you're going to get when you log into Dockge, when you've got some stuff up and running. This is what you're going to see, or at least something similar to it, right? So up at the top left, we've got the Dockge logo space. We've got compose right here. We've got a search, so we can search through our Docker services that are running. Like I've got Dazzle and Hedgedoc. I don't know what this home is. I don't know what that is, but it's there. I've got home chart, Matomo, Monica, Riot, and root. Again, I'm not sure why that's there, but it is, and I don't care. So basically, next to that, we've got our main area here with active, exited, and inactive. So 7 active, 1 exited, 0 inactive. We've got this Docker run here that I love. So let's say you've got a Docker compose, like where it's just like Docker run dash P80-V and some volumes and then an image. Like it's just one kind of run-on sentence, right? You can copy and paste that into this area right here and click convert to compose. So let's actually do that real quick. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm actually just going to grab this from Voice Chat. I'm gonna copy this and I'm gonna paste that in there, and I'm gonna get rid of the slashes just because I can't find another good example for some reason, right? So I'm gonna come back over to here. I'm gonna paste that in and click convert. And right there, it converted it. So we got a version 3.3, our services, our Voice Chat server, restart of always, ports, container name, image, network. Just that quick and easy, it converted it and it's got us over here already. So I'm just gonna give this a name and I'm just gonna give it the name of Voice Chat. Now, what I wanna do is actually jump over to my dev environment here so that we can see something. So if I do ls, right, we can see all of the containers that I have running: Dazzle, Hedgedoc, Homechart, Matomo, Monica, and Riot. And we can see Dazzle, Hedgedoc, Homechart, Matomo, Monica, and Riot. There's a couple of orphans in here that I'm not sure what's going on with them. I just haven't dealt with it yet. But now the reason I bring this up is this, right? So we've got our compose.yaml file over here. We've got our Docker images, our Docker containers running over here. And we can see all of those different Docker containers here have their own folders. The reason for that is if we do like an ls, if we do a cd into Dazzle, if I do an ls, there's a compose.yaml file there. And if I do a nano compose.yaml, there is the compose file, right? So why does this matter? Let's exit out and do that. So now we're back. Let's clear my screen. Oops, and do an ls. So we've got our six containers there. What I'm going to do is click save. Down here under my stupid face, you can't see it. I apologize. It says saved. Over here, it's got a compose.yaml file listed. It's running on, or it's got port 3009 there. It's not running, right? It says start. But if we do ls again, now we have where did it go? Voice chat right there. So why am I so excited about this? Basically, if you deploy a container in, say, Portainer, for instance, right? You go in and you go to stacks and you drop in your Docker Compose and you click deploy. It's just stored basically as text in a database entry. And if you if something goes wrong or you update your system incorrectly, or let's say you shut down Portainer to do an update, but you for some reason do something stupid like I've done in the past and delete the volume for that and then redeploy Portainer, all of those containers are going to be basically, you know, outside of Portainer, and Portainer can't do anything with that anymore. And that's super frustrating. I've had it happen more than once. I have gone out of my way to make sure it doesn't happen again in the future. But when you deploy a container in Dockge, it automatically creates a compose.yaml file that's saved on your server, so that if you have to do an update, you don't have to worry about possibly not being able to administer that Docker image through your container manager, in this case, Dockge. I know that's a long, convoluted way of saying that it does it better. But that's basically what it is, right? So now if I come back over here to Dockge, I can click start. And it's going to show me everything that it's doing, which again is something that Portainer doesn't do. It's just like it spins and spins and spins and spins and spins, and then eventually it will either deploy or it won't. And here again, it deployed, and now we've got real-time logs of our container showing us what's going on. So we don't have to deploy it and then go back to another screen and then go find the icon and then go into logs and scroll through the logs and deal with all of that. That's not how this works. When we deploy it, we immediately see everything that's going on and we immediately see the logs for that container. And I absolutely love it. It's the simplest thing, but it's so intuitive in my opinion, right? So now if I click this, just like that, There's my voice chat server. I didn't have to jump around and go click somewhere else, go back to my stack and then click the port and do all of that. It's all right here. All of the information that you need about whatever container you're looking at is right here on this page. And let's say for some reason, let's actually go back to voice chat here. And let's say I need to edit this. You know, I can just come over to this and I can see, you know what, I don't, 3009 doesn't work for me. I want it on 3010, and I can click save and restart. It's gonna go ahead and restart and give this just a second. I love, again, that it's giving me active information like, hey, your system hasn't frozen. It's actually showing me that it took 10 and a half seconds to deploy. I know it's a little thing, but I like to know what's going on. Okay, so now our voice chat Docker container is stopped. Let's see if we just click start. Let's make sure that it's actually going to redeploy it on 3010 instead of 3009. And there it goes. So that's the process of maybe making a modification to your Docker Compose or your compose.yaml file, in this case, your stack. There's a different name for that everybody uses, but basically you just stop it, make your change, save and restart your container, and it's just that simple. Now, I do want to say that, again, this is very early development. I don't necessarily think I would put this in production just yet, but it's definitely got a lot of cool features in it that I really do dig about how to manage a Docker container environment. It does a lot of the stuff that Portainer does, but here's the thing, like Portainer is a great tool. In fact, it's what I used to get familiar with Docker and how to deploy a Docker image and that sort of thing. However, Docker or Portainer rather is it's got its community edition, and that's great, but it's obviously, it has to make money. It's a company. They have employees, they have salaries, they have overhead, they have offices, they have all kinds of stuff. So they have to make money. So they've got their business edition as well. So a lot of the features and things that Portainer is doing, it does very well, but it also is very much more geared towards business clients. Whereas I feel like, and I might be wrong about this, I feel like Dockge is meant for just simply deploying Docker containers in a simple, easy to understand manner that gives you a few different ways that you can do it. So let's take a look at getting Dockge deployed. I've got another Proxmox container set up and running so that we can do this quickly. But let's get this new instance of Dockge deployed. We'll take a look at actually going through and setting up some different containers in a couple of different ways so that you can see it. But I hope you're as excited about this as I am. Again, if you are excited about this, please go over to the GitHub repository and give it a star. That's the equivalent of giving it a thumbs up here on YouTube. And it helps them achieve certain goals that helps them get funding sometimes, or gives them access to certain things that they wouldn't otherwise have access to without a certain number of stars. So with that little side rant out of the way, let's go deploy Dockge. Okay, so here we are. We're on the GitHub repository for Dockge. I'm just going to come over here and click the copy right there for this Docker compose. And then we're going to come over here to my Docker test environment over on Proxmox. Again, you don't have to do this in Proxmox. It's just my test environment. So set it up however you want to set it up on your environment. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a Docker compose, and I'm going to paste that in there. Now, there are a couple of things in here that I want to change. But let's start at the top. We've got a version 3.8 Docker compose file here. That's fine. Our service is going to be Dockge, and our image is Lewis Lamb's Dockge with a tag of 1. Change that to latest. The version 1 still has some stuff in it that needs to be fixed. If you go to latest, it was updated recently within the last couple of hours at the time of recording this video. So change that to latest. You'll have a much better time. Next, we've got a restart policy, even less stopped. Our port, basically this is going to run on port 5001 by default, but if you need to change that, if you're already using port 5001, change the left-hand side of that colon. Don't change the colon or anything after it. I'm gonna put that back on 5001 though. That's where I want it. Next, we've got a Docker volume. We've got a volume that connects to the Docker socket. You need that so that this can connect to the Docker socket and communicate with Docker. So just don't bother that line at all. Next, we need to know where are we going to store Dockage's information. Like when it deploys, where are we going to store that on our server? So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna say home Dockage, just like that. Next, we've got some additional information here if you need to do anything additional. Here's more information that I encourage you to read. Where are we going to store our stacks, right? Basically, where are we going to store our folder structure for our compose.yaml files? Now, we can put this basically wherever. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do home Docker stacks, and I'm going to do home Docker stacks. And that volume is now set, but we actually have an environment variable that we need to give that same bit of information to just once, not twice though. Home Docker stacks, right? And this is where it will store all of that folder structure for those compose.yaml files. Once we're happy with this, we can do Control O and Enter and Control X, and then let's clear our screen and do Docker compose up-d. If you run this and you get an error like Docker compose that isn't recognized, it means you've got an older version of Docker compose and you need to get the new version. Or the other thing you could do is just come back here and put in a dash. That's the old version. Version 2 doesn't require the dash in the middle there. I'm gonna go ahead and hit enter. So now the container is going to go through, the system is gonna go through and pull all of the resources that it needs to deploy this container. In a minute or two, it'll be done and it'll tell us that our container is up and running. And then we can go over and take a look at our Dockge instance. And there we go. After just a couple of moments, everything is up and running. So the next thing we needed to do is figure out the IP address of our server here. So what I'm gonna do is just do an IPA. And then it's on .10, so I'm gonna copy that, and then I'm gonna put on port 5001, And yeah, I know it's not secure, that's fine. And if you've ever set up Uptime Kuma, this login page looks very, very similar, and I love it. It's the simple things that impress me sometimes. So anyway, we're gonna create an admin account. We've only got English right now. I'm sure that at some point they would love to have translators for this. So if you're multilingual, I bet they would love to have you go over there and offer to do translations. That's just speculation, but just know that right now this is only available in English. So something to keep in mind. So I'm gonna go ahead and create my user and click create. And down here, you can't see it, but it says success added. We're good to go. So again, this is what it's gonna look like when you first log in. There's nothing here. So let's fix that. Like let's deploy things a couple of different ways. Let's first do just a compose. And this is just a generic YAML file in there for Nginx. But let's come back over to my previous Dockge instance here. You know, let's just go ahead and deploy Dazzle. I'm a big fan. Dazzle's great. So we're just gonna go ahead and run this. So now we've got our Dazzle Docker compose. So what we're gonna do, we're just gonna paste it in just like that. And it's gonna run on, like, basically it's a version 2 service Dazzle image Dazzle container name Dazzle restart unless stopped ports 8888 on mapped to 8080. It's got a volume that just connects to the Docker socket as well. And we've got a network. We don't necessarily need that, but it's there. So we're gonna leave it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna copy this into there and I'm going to click save. Right. So now in theory, if I come back over to here to this, do ls, right? Let's do cd home and then ls and then cd docker ls cd stacks. Again, this is where we told it to store our stacks as we're deploying them, and then do an ls. There's Dazzle. So if I do cd into Dazzle and an ls, we've got a compose. So we'll do a nano compose.yaml. And hey, look, this is the file that it generated by us creating it over here. Again, I know this is a silly thing to be excited about, but I'm going to show you why it matters here in a moment. So once we're happy with this, we're going to click start. It's pulling everything. It's giving us a timer. And here in just a second, it'll be done. Cool. Just like that. It says that it's active. It says that it's active up here as well. We've got our live terminal down here saying that it's accepting connections. All of this looks really good. Now, I'm going to click 8888 right there, and there's Dazzle. There's Dazzle. Now, here's one of the things that makes me excited about this. And I know, again, it's the little details. It's really the little details that make the most difference when I'm checking out something new, right? So let me show you what I'm talking about here. If we come back over to Dockge, you'll notice at no point did I put in the IP address of this server. I didn't put that, like, over on Portainer. You have to go into the environment and then you have to put in the IP address of the environment in the local environment in order to be able to click the port and have it open up. If we come over here up to the top right and click on settings, general, primary host, or primary host name rather, local host is by default. There's nothing there, but it was still like, hey, I bet you just want to deploy this on the IP address that you're currently on, right? And I love that they had the forward thinkingness, which isn't a word, the ability to be forward thinking enough to be like, hey, I bet that pisses people off quite a bit using Portainer. Like, I've actually created videos to show people how to fix the 0.0.0.0 error from Portainer. And they're like, no, we're just not gonna do that. We're gonna make this easy from the jump. So if I jump back over to here, like, I can click auto get and it'll automatically fill it in, but I don't need to. And I can just click save and it's there, but I didn't need to do that. I didn't need to put in the primary host name in order for this to work. If I just come over and I click that port, hey, look, it just works. And there was no, I didn't have to put any thought into it because they did. And I love that. So we've deployed a container here, dead simple to do. And again, it created the file for us on our server. So while we're here on this server, let's do a control X. Oops, let's actually clear my screen. And then let's go back a directory, right? Like so. And so we've just got Dazzle in here for right now. Let's go back over to my other instance. Let's do one for Hedgedock. I'm a big fan of Hedgedock lately. I've been using it a lot, right? So we're gonna do cd into Hedgedock, and then we're gonna do ls, right? There's our compose. I'm gonna do nano compose, and I'm just gonna grab this right here. And I'm just gonna copy that. Then I'm gonna come back over to my tutorial here, and I'm gonna do mkdir hedge doc, And then we're going to cd into hedge doc. I'm going to do a nano compose.yaml. And I'm just going to paste that in. Now, I am going to need to change one thing in here because of the command domain is 10 and not 7. Right? So now I'm going to clear my screen again. I'm going to let's just do an ls. So we've got our compose file in here. If I go back a directory, do an ls. We've got two different directories in here for Dazzle, the one we deployed in Dockge, and then the hedge doc folder that we just created in the command line. So if I come back over to here and I come up and I say scan, hey, look, there's the folder that we just created with the compose.yaml file that we just created. So now if I want to, I can just click start and it's gonna go ahead and pull all of the files and folders and everything that it needs to deploy this container. So I love that that the folks that are building Dockge were like, hey, let's let people deploy a Docker compose file natively in the application, or let's let them convert a Docker CLI into a compose so that they can deploy it that way. Or let's say they've already got a bunch of compose files that they want to put on their server. They can just say migrate those from one server to another and just import them with one click of a button and then deploy them as they see fit. I absolutely love the thought that was put into all of the different things that they're doing with Dockge. And again, this is still very early in development. Obviously, the developers made a post about it on Reddit, so it got some traction there. It's already got like 450 something stars. Again, you should go give them a star if you think this project is worth making note of or taking note of or following or whatever. I think they're going to do something really, really cool with this. In fact, let's jump back over to here so that we can take a look at this. It's pulled everything. It's created everything. There is, again, our logs in real time doing the things that it needs to do. And now it's like, hey, we're listening on port 3000 right there. And it's running a health check. So let's go ahead and click on port 3000. And there's HedgeDoc, just that simple and easy. So let me know in the comment section down below what your thoughts are on Dockge. Of course, again, I can't emphasize this enough. Go check out their GitHub page, their Reddit post. Again, links to everything will be in the description down below, so you can check that out. If you run into issues or complications or whatever, be sure to let them know over on their GitHub page. Posting a question here might get an answer, but chances are it probably won't. Because again, I'm not the developer of this project, and likely the viewers of this won't be either, unless the developers of this project happen to come over and check out the video. But I'm super excited about this. I hope you are as well. And I think I've rambled enough. So thank you for spending a few minutes of your day with me today, and I'll talk to you in the next video.